Well, there's so much negativity usually in sports, and when there's a good story that comes up, it's nice to be able to highlight it, so we wanted to do that. NJIT was riding a 51-game losing streak before it beat Bryant 61-51 last night, so they've gone 702 days without a win, and with that victory, they're now 1-18. Jim Engles is their head coach, and he joins us now on the Michael K. Show. Jim, how you doing?
Great, Michael. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, please. Congratulations, first of all. And what did it mean to finally get this humongo monkey off your back?
I don't know. Maybe I'm naive to this whole thing, but just being a new head coach, I was really just focused on the next game. I know that sounds cliche, but it hadn't really started to hit me. And now I've realized that the enormity of it by just all the media attention we received. So I probably should have prepared myself better for this time. So.
How about the kids, though? I mean, coaches always say that, you know, it's one game at a time. Don't think too far ahead. But, you know, the kids have to suffer the slings and arrows, and I'm sure they were taunted about it from people and even probably from the opposition. So how did they react after the victory yesterday?
Oh, you're so right. I mean, you're 18, 19, 20 years old. Your identity is that of a basketball player. I mean, I know they're college students, obviously, but when you're a Division I player, and no matter what division you are, when you're a player, you're a player, and that's what you know yourself as. And if you're not having any success on the court, it sort of makes everything else a little bit harder. So when you're walking around campus, you know, you can't really put your head up, and sometimes you feel a little down, and sometimes people will take shots at you, which is really not the best thing in the world, but that's life. And but the great thing about our kids is that they are so high character that we have not hid from it. We've sort of gone out and embraced it, and we've talked about every day about just going out and competing and trying to execute. And you know, we don't have any seniors in our program. We've only had one kid who's really been involved with in the program since it's gone Division I. This is our third year. So we have a lot of new kids, and they're all learning to win, and we've started to see it recently. So am I surprised that we won? Not really, because in practice, you know, two games ago, we played at Loyola. We were down 19. We were able to come back, and it was a tie game with 4 minutes to go in the game, and we played pretty well against Penn. We just couldn't score. Just had a hard time scoring. And then we came out last night, and we were able to really play well from the start to the finish.
What was that locker room like after the game?
I don't know if I'll ever be around to win a national championship, but you know, when I coached at Columbia prior to being the head coach here, we had gone through a little bit of the same situation. We got the job, and we were 0-14 in the Ivy League, and we were 2-25, and our first win was at Sacred Heart, and it was like you know, it's like almost cutting down the nets type of deal. You know, people were throwing water at each other and hugging, and it was the same type of way yesterday. It was just so much fun to see the joy on our guys' faces.
And that's what's cool, and that's why I wanted to talk to you, Jim, because, you know, at this level, these kids don't deserve to suffer like that. They're not, I mean, you are a Division I program, but it's not Kentucky, it's not North Carolina, it's not Duke. And, you know, they're trying to get an education, they're trying to have fun. Obviously, they love the game, and they deserve to have a little joy. And for them to win yesterday, I mean, 702 days without a victory, that's a long time. So they must have been elated.
There's an image that will stick with me for the rest of my life. I mean, at the end there, you know, I'm hoping the clock just keeps counting down.
And right.
I was scared to death. You know, I'm a new head coach, and we haven't really been in enough games in the last minute to really be tested, for me to be tested personally. So I'm just saying, guys, just keep it at 10, keep it at 10, because I didn't want to screw it up at the end. So I'm looking at it, and at the end, though, we're at the foul line, and the game is basically over, and we're going to the foul line just to finish it up. There's a few seconds left, and there's just, they all got together, and they just hugged each other, and you could just see it. They all were just, it was one of those really, you know, meaningful embrace type things, and that is something I'll never forget.
You know what's always intrigued me about hockey and college basketball is that you've just battled and battled and battled, and then the coaches shake their hands, you know? You know, they walk past the scorer's table, and I would always think to myself, if I'm the losing coach, I want to spit in the other guy's face. So 18 straight games, you had to be the losing coach. How much better was the handshake yesterday?
It was great. And you know what made it great was you know, just the way Tim O'Shea handled it. You know, he's the head coach of Bryant. He was so gracious, and he pulled me aside. He said, listen, I know how hard it has been for you guys, and I've watched all your games, and you guys have played hard from the get-go, and you would never know that you guys have lost all these games in a row. So he was very gracious, and that meant a lot. And in all the games that we played, you know, as in this career, you become friends, and obviously it's a very competitive business, but everybody's been so supportive to me personally. I've gotten so many texts and so many emails as we've gone through this, and the kids. I said, when you go through some adversity, you really start to see who your friends are and who really cares. And it's been great for me because a lot of people have really helped me through this.
Jim Engles is the head coach of NJIT, and it snapped a 51-game losing streak yesterday with a victory over Bryant. You know, sometimes they say, coach, and in all sorts of sports, you have to learn how to win before you could really start to win. So do you believe that now, okay, they've got this taste of it, that they can win some games?
Oh, no doubt. I'm just so happy now, you know, after playing 18 games and all the teaching that goes into it to try to make the kids better. You know, we film all our games and we'll watch our game afterwards. And, you know, when you lose, there's a lot of things, there's a lot of reasons why, and you can nitpick and you can show and say, hey, this is where we lost this game or this is where we lost this game. Well, now, tomorrow on our bus ride, you know, the glamorous Division I, we got to get on the bus and go to Farmville, Virginia tomorrow, 7.5-hour bus ride to
wow.
go to Longwood on Saturday. But to make the bus ride a little quicker, we'll go over the film, and now I can point out to them, hey, this is where we won the game. This is how you guys did it. This is what we did to take control of the game, and this is how we kept control. So now it's a different way to learn, and, you know, I think confidence breeds confidence, and I think the kids are so confident right now, it's going to be a lot of fun.
Ironically enough, your last victory before last night was at Longwood on February 19th of 07, so maybe that's where you start a winning streak. Right?
I guess. I'm taking one win as a winning streak right now. That's what I don't care about two. I just want one. That's fine with me.
You want to give some love to some of the players that were instrumental in the win yesterday? You want to mention their names? I'm sure they haven't got much play lately.
Yeah, Dan Stonkus, really, he's a junior. He's a redshirt junior for us. He's the one who's been with the program since this is our third year in the classification process of being a Division I program. So he's been the one guy who's been within the program since the start, and he's played in every game that was involved in the streak. So I'm really excited for him. I mean, he had a 4.0 last semester. He's a mechanical engineering major. I mean, the kid's a genius. He's intimidating to sort of be in the same room with. He's so smart.
Uh-huh.
But he's been great, and I'm really happy for him. And one of the other guys that really stood out, especially last night, is one of our freshman point guards, Teddy Schickel. You know, the kid didn't play our last two games. You know, I sort of tried to shorten up the rotation and trying to do anything sort of to get us out of this. And, you know, one of our other point guard, our backup point guard, got sick. He had 102 fever, so he couldn't play. So Teddy comes in, and he made a huge basket to stop their run. And then he goes to the foul line, and he made every big foul shot. And he was really the one. That was the image at the end, but they sort of hugged him. And just to see him, because he comes in the gym, and just to show you the character of our kids, he's the type of kid, you know, he's not playing, and he's in the gym on Monday night, and he's shooting. We had already practiced in the morning. He's in the gym at night, at 9 o'clock at night, doing extra shooting on his own. So I'm so excited for him.
Well, I'm glad for you, Jim, and I'm glad that we could pop you on during the show and you know, give you some appreciation for snapping that losing streak. Again, it's great for the kids, and it's great for you. I'm sure you slept a little bit better last night.
It's the first time I've slept in a little while. So.
Well, be good. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Michael.
You got it. That's Jim Engles. He's the head coach of NJIT. 61-51 over Bryant. They snap a 51-game losing streak. And, you know, we don't usually do that sort of stuff on the show, but I thought it'd be nice to do it today. And congratulations to the kids at NJIT.